think of killing himself. Nobody had a doubt or anything to do with his health. Wasn't ever that kind of gentleman that needed help. Just an everyday bloke trying to handle what he'd been dealt. But it was steadily more difficult to conceal when he was too proud to reveal the loneliness. Fear that he feels envious of those uneven kill. Cause from where he's sitting, that disposition is completely unreal. It's not like his car's lost any one of its wheels. Just as if they'd been clamped up, secured and sealed. He was flown the white flag and shown he'd yield. Yet the black dog relentlessly honed his heel in a planet of 6 bills. Still not a soul to understand. Too long ago, relinquished the upper hand. Got him suffocated, tightened like a cummerbund. Recalls what happy is, that's for another man. Coils with his inner turmoil, cups it, tucks it neatly, keeps him sweetly unflustered. People of prominence are just as likely, even if they're as hyped as hyphy, bright and feisty. They might be the John Conrads and Steve Rogers. Gold medals, best and fairest, they got notches. Cars and ski lodges, they might even be doctors. Tragic character, silver screen operas, convinced that they imposters. Roll with one or ones that made themselves, now think they're done for. And they can't talk, someone on the mute button. Men dying, bachelor pads, nobody knew nothing. The view here's as grey as vacant car parks. Don't ask why, it's hard to laugh. It's 2 a.m, he's wandering streets alone. Can't remember these avenues, they feel unknown. Listen to the drone of a distant truck, compression brakes. Afraid of the frailty of the things he'd set in place. He's had better days, some worse than others. Not the kind of fella proud of sleeping in under the covers. Close up the shutters, take the phone off the hook. And if they inquire, reply was crook. It overtook him too long ago and took his honor slow but surely. In prison like S. Corby, 17